And second, you spoke about the Shishubala. You see, understand? Krishna really waited. Shishubala. To wake up and come to the non-violence and enlightenment. Align himself back. But Shishubala was going to the extreme. He started destroying the enlightenment ecosystem built by Krishna. Now, he has to see the violence, non-violence from the larger scale. He should not be see, if Krishna did not kill Shishubala, it will be like a Krishna was violent to the larger humanity by letting the enlightenment ecosystem be destroyed. So, to be non-violent to the larger humanity, even then he gave a long rope to Shishubala. Finally, he has to cut the head of Shishubala and give enlightenment to Shishubala. If you read the story, the life, Atma of Shishubala reaches directly Krishna's feet. If Krishna wanted, he could have killed Shishubala by keeping Shishubala far away. He did not do. He killed Shishubala. He cut the head of the Shishubala in his breathing space. I should say, that's the most compassionate liberation he gave literally in his very breathing space. I should say, the Shishubala's cut head fell at the feet of Krishna and the life got absorbed into Krishna Charana. I will say both are absolute non-violent acts.